Pretty good.
Tired.
More tired than usual, or? Mm-hmm.
Regular tired.
Okay, I gotcha. Okay, so just so I know the history. So you guys moved from Texas after the hurricane. Mm-hmm. Before that, you were going to Texas Children's. Ah, you know to bring your own blanket. That's good. It's always freezing. Then you moved here, and then you had trouble getting in to see a doctor at first, and finally went to Miami Children's. Is that right?
We had to change over the insurance.
Okay.
So that took a whole month. And
sure.
Then it was going to take like another month just to get the referral, so at that point her health declined, so we went to Miami Beach Hospital there.
Mount Sinai?
Yeah, Mount Sinai. From Mount Sinai, they took her to the Children's Hospital.
Okay. What happened that your health
declined? Actually, we didn't even know that she was so bad. I mean, we knew that she was bad when she started, like, turning purple and vomiting and stuff.
Okay.
But once we got to the hospital, her oxygen was actually down into the 70s.
Okay.
Which is really bad. We didn't realize it was that bad.
Okay.
And that was, like, on 5%, with her oxygen turned up to 5. So, they stabilized her there at Mount Sinai, and then they transferred her
Children's.
Right.
Okay. So were you feeling bad for a while, or was it just like one day?
I had been off my medicine for 2 days.
Okay. So that's when
you went. I was going to walk to the store with my sister for a little bit, but because it's not that far.
Right.
And I couldn't even get to the end of the road.
So what I saw from the notes was that you had ran out of the, was it the ambrisentan?
Right, the terrace.
And everything else you still had, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you really noticed the difference just 2 days off that medicine and you were feeling really bad?
Yeah. They told me that I was going to be fine without it for a couple of days, but I wasn't.
Okay, sure, absolutely.
She used that that endothelin blocker.
Right.
So.
Yeah, absolutely. How's everything been going since then? How have you been feeling when you're back on your medicine?
Good. I don't really do much. I don't really leave my house. I don't like to leave my house either,
because
I don't know, I like being home.
Okay. What do you like to do for fun?
I walk a little bit. I try.
Okay. How far can you walk before you have to stop?
I don't really know, because I'll like just walk on the sidewalk, so I'll stop anytime I have to.
Okay.
So, and then I'm not that far from my house.
Okay. Like a block?
I'm just like on the street.
Okay.
I would say about 500 feet.
You said 500 feet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like,
all right.
We're trying to walk around this campus to find this building.
I know,
it's
huge.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we're a little ways from the garage, too.
Yeah.
So that day when you were feeling really sick, you said you're turning purple and vomiting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anything else? Any feeling like you couldn't breathe? Chest pain?
Yeah, she couldn't breathe because usually she walks to the store in the morning to with her sister who buys school lunch for the day, but this day she like got stuck in the middle of the stairs and she's like, I can't get it the rest of the way up.
Okay.
So,
okay.
And we did eventually get her up the stairs, but it was hard, and then she was just in really bad shape at that point.
Because I had my medicine in my stomach, it came out, and so I was taking a shower so I could put a new one in.
Mm-hmm.
And something happened with the toilet, and I freaked out, and I started, like, I couldn't breathe, and I was shaking, and it was scary.
Oh, okay. So you got super nervous. That's the Remodulin, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, so you're taking digoxin still?
Mm-hmm.
The warfarin?
Yes.
And then they switched you to the macitentan, or did they give you the script for the ambrisentan?
No, they switched to the macitentan.
Okay.
Actually, it's hard to get Letairis here in Florida, so that's why they switched her.
Okay. And how many, do you know how many milligrams it is?
Yeah.
That's okay.
I don't know offhand.
That's fine. And Tadalafil, still taken?
Yeah.
Okay. And then the Remodulin pump you have, right?
Yes.
Any allergies?
No.
And then I know about the basic surgeries that you've had. Any childhood surgeries before that?
No.
Okay. so they closed the PDA.
Right.
And that was in 2013,
is that right? 2012, I think. Mm-hmm. No, not 2012. What am I saying? Yeah, 2012. Okay.
No other surgeries?
No, that's all.
Family history of health problems?
No.
Everyone's healthy, mm-hmm. Living?
Yes.
Perfect. Any history of heart problems in the family, heart disease? No history of hypertension?
Mm-mm.
Okay, great. And then who lives at home?
Just me and her sister, and her sister's 12.
Okay. So you're the big sister. Ooh, big responsibility.
She likes to sleep in the living room, so I just like... Because she likes to turn the light on, and uh-huh. I don't like it. So, she just sleeps in the living room a lot.
Okay.
I don't know.
Well, however you keep peace in the house. Whatever works.
I mean, she doesn't really like being in the room anyways.
Okay. Any cats and dogs at home?
No.
Okay. No pets? Carpets?
No.
Okay. We always ask these questions. It's just respiratory stuff, because this is pollen clinic.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone who smokes?
No.
House? Okay.
And no bugs either.
Got lucky. No bugs. It's not that bad on the beach. There's not so many bugs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's hard, but...
Oh.
Okay, so today, any fevers or chills? Weight loss? Any vision changes? Any runny nose?
Right. I get blood in my nose sometimes.
From when it gets really dry?
When I wake up in the morning, I get like blood in my nose a lot.
Does it run or?
No, I just like it's stuck. Bits. It feels weird.
Okay.
When I was in the hospital, they like put like petroleum jelly in it. And I don't know if it helps or not.
Yeah, sometimes people do that. Usually you get it because oxygen is so dry. Unless you have a humidifier that you attach it to at home. It's
super dry. I
think I
do, it's still just dry.
Yeah, you can use the jelly. It helps. Chest pain,